I've been on YouTube for more than 5 years, so getting many kinds of messages and emails. Some people saying like this, which I really appreciate and grateful. Wow, I'm honored. But sometimes I'm like, it's actually quite a lot. Anyway, this is one of the common messages I often get. And I thought many other people would be curious about it. Because I often hear that Japan and Korea don't seem to be so different, especially from Western perspective. So as someone who has dated both Japanese and Korean women in the past,Let me share my thoughts on that. It's gonna be just based on my personal experience and what I have often seen. So I'm gonna be quite general ganging. あれ?あ、ごめん、間違えた、もう一回やるし。So I'm gonna be quite general ganging. I know. This is fucking embarrassing. So I'm going to be quite generalizing. But it doesn't apply to all the women in Japan and Korea, right? Because we are all different in the end. But I hope I can give you the overall tendency and dating difference between Japan and South Korea. The first big difference I've noticed is that Korean women are much more beauty conscious. Of course, Japanese women also care about appearance or makeup stuff. But Korean women go to extremes. For example, most Japanese women don't care about this. They don't think they needed to get rid of that. But many Korean women do. And even a small tiny wrinkle mark or anything on their face or body, they want to fix it. By the way, what do you think about this woman? Do you think she's chubby? According to my Korean friends, she would be considered too chubby in Korea. And they say, this woman would be a normal size. Are you fucking kidding me? Basically, the beauty standards are way more stricter and severe in South Korea. And maybe that's why most Korean women I've talked to had multiple plastic surgeries on their face. So anyone who wants to date in South Korea, you're gonna have to be totally okay with that. I'm saying this because maybe some men are not happy about it. Completely changing face like that. But it's totally normal and even a positive thing in South Korea.
整形とか顔をちょっといじるとかっていうのはどっちかというとその手入れをしっかりしてるっていうような目線で見られるんですよね。日本で言うと何ですかね、マッサージ行ったんだねぐらいな感覚ですかね、価値観で言うと。
Even Korean men care about that a lot. So I think Korean women have really high standards for men about appearance. Having said that, another difference I found is that Korean women tend to care about your height, and you have to be much taller as a guy. While for Japanese women, it's important your face is handsome.More than whether you are tall or not. So if you look at the male idol groups in Korea like BTS, many of them are quite tall for Asian men. While Japanese idol groups like Arashi, they are not so tall, but all of them have a beautiful handsome face. So maybe that's kind of requirement. Now this doesn't always apply, of course. But actually, Korean women often told me,あ、日本人にしては意外と背高いね。Often praising me like that, and seemed like that was a big reason they chose to go on a date with me. I wasn't sure why they care about that, but according to my Korean friends, Korean women want to feel that as a girl, I'm being protected and loved by him a lot. They have that kind of desire strongly. So as a guy, you need to show her that clearly.Which brings my next point. So let's say your Japanese girlfriend gives you 5 messages a day. Skype call just 10 minutes every night or stuff like that. But if you are dating a Korean woman, it would be like this. And if you don't communicate with her like that, she might start doubting that you are cheating or something.
韓国の方とこう付き合ってやっぱり愛情深いっていうところは本当に感じてて、連絡がマメっていうのも束縛とか嫉妬っていうのも結構そういう愛情表現がすごく深いので、やっぱその分相手にこう求めてくる。
It comes down to the idea that men should cherish women a lot, which I didn't know about. So one time, I was going for dinner with a Korean woman. Usually my jokes don't work and I'm miserably failing. But that day, she was laughing a lot at my jokes and we were having so much fun. And she even said that we should go on a second date and I'm extremely happy. But when we leaving the restaurant and I said, 今日割り勘でいいっしょ? And suddenly she became like this. Seemed like that was so unbelievable and shocking to her. And she was saying like, てめえ一体どんな男だよ? In the end, we never go on second date and never even meet again since then. Basically, I screwed up as always.But why?
日本よりは絶対にあの女性を大切にするっていう韓国人男性がもうそれが当たり前なので、その日本人男性はちょっと人気ないんですよね。冷たいというか愛情表現が薄いっていうふうに思われるんです。僕もそれはよく言われてます。 本当に好きなのっていうふうな形でよく言われてたので。
So you have to constantly show your affection a lot like this and make it clear. But I don't think many Japanese women expect like that from men. On the contrary, they might feel embarrassed or not comfortable. If you are doing those stuff a lot, so you might feel kind of distance from them.But it doesn't mean they don't like you or anything like that. It's just not in your culture. Now we all know that Japan is all about kawaii, right? That's so important for Japanese women, which often causing them to be submissive, passive, and not speaking their mind. While Korean women are more like strong, because they wanna be independent, confident, and straightforward. As feminism is getting more and more common in South Korea. And some people say that's one of the reasons why the marriage and birth rates are getting lower and lower.
意思表現ですねがもうストレート、日本だとやっぱりどうしてもこう回りくどくというか柔らげて言う、あの韓国ではそういうことを柔らかく言うっていう言い方が多分なくないというかと伝わらなくなってしまうので、自分の意思が、意思表現が本当に全部ストレートです。私は怒ってる時は怒ってるって人がたくさんいるところでももうそのままアピールしますし、プライドっていう部分高いというか芯を持ってるので僕、私は間違ってないんだっていう芯を持ってるのでそのまま謝らない。日本人女性に言われたのが、韓国人女性はやっぱり厳しいので韓国女性と付き合える日本人男性は本当に優しい人かド M しか付き合えないよっていうふうにいう表現してました。
I know this applies to both countries, but it's way stronger in South Korea. Probably by the influence of Confucianism. One of the teaching is that you must respect elders and parents a lot. So you should be extremely careful when meeting her parents. If the parents are not happy on anything about you, she's gonna have to give up on you. Because family comes first, much more than a boyfriend or girlfriend.By the way, this is not so uncommon in Japan, but in South Korea, that's extremely rare and taboo. My Korean friend said that parents would never allow that. So when it comes to marriage or relationship, you do need permission a lot, much more than in Japan. But it doesn't mean Korean women don't wanna date any foreign men. Actually, it was slightly rising. After the pandemic though,It's getting lower, understandably. But still 70%, right? Which is much higher than in Japan. Now, this is just my personal opinion. But I think Korean people are generally more open about dating foreigners, especially dating Western people. First of all, they speak English better than Japanese on average. Secondly, they have more American influence and Christian influence as Christianity is rising there. And they go study abroad a lot more than we do. So they are more Westernized or globalized overall. It doesn't mean South Korea isbetter than Japan about everything. But if you're a Western guy, Korean women would be culturally more similar and dating would be easier in my opinion. Anyway, here you have it. I hope it's gonna help you in some way. But I know, that was a lot of generalizing. So I wanna emphasize, whether dating Japanese women, Korean women, or any womenIt's important to see each person individually.
感じる日本と韓国って本当に別の国なので、全く全然違う。あの同じ感覚で見たら意思の疎通が多分全然できなくなってしまうので、やっぱり韓国女性とこう相手のことをすごく理解するためにたくさん話さないと、やっぱりちょっと理解が、はい、難しいかなって。